Hi, my name's Justin Ahmed. I designed the Predator Pack for the serious predator hunter. I've been coyote hunting since I was 9 years old. Every time I go out, I'm trying to get all my gear with me, and it seems every year that goes by, we end up getting more gadgets and toys to take with us when we're going predator hunting. I felt there was a real need for something of this quality, and with the design just specifically for the predator hunter. Lo and behold, we found out once we got it done, there's several different applications it works real good for. Now everybody's got their elk hunting pack. This is my day pack that I use when I'm elk hunting during archery season and when I'm deer hunting. This is a Jim Horn Signature Series pack. It's also made by Black's Creek Guide Gear. Just an exceptional pack. It fits well around your waist. The shoulder straps are fully adjustable, fits very well. It's a great pack to have. Several different compartments to hold your calls and stuff. Now with the help of Black's Creek Guide Gear, we went ahead and designed the Predator Pack. And one thing that we really needed was a cushion. I find myself setting up in the winter time when there's 2 feet of snow on the ground. I wanted a cushion that was big enough so the snow wouldn't come up over the top of it. It would protect me. Also thick enough that I can set it on some rocks and be comfortable for quite a while. This also doubles as a shooting rest. You can stand it up on the side, hold it here, lay your gun on top of it, or if you need to, you can get down in the prone position, lay down and use it to shoot off of. It's not the greatest shooting rest in the world, but it will work a lot better than nothing. If this is all you have, you're gonna be glad you had it along. The packs come in the new Predator camouflage, which I think is just a phenomenal pattern, and also the Advantage Max 1. You got different choices that way. Now, you've either just purchased a Predator pack or you're inquiring about one. There's several different features on this I think you're gonna be really impressed with. First thing you wanna do is go ahead and open the main compartment. And all these compartments have covers over the zippers to keep the rain out. It's a waterproof material anyway, but if you go swimming in the creek with it, you're gonna get wet. Go ahead and pull this out. I'll show you what that is later on. There's a separate compartment in here with Velcro on the sides. I take this and this holds my remote control for the Predator or the Fox Pro. Works real good. Okay. One thing you want to know about the straps. Seems like there's an awful lot of straps here. These two that are clipped on the ends, go ahead and take them off. Now we're going to redo these straps. They come from the factory. They didn't get them quite the way I wanted them, but they got everything in here. That's the important thing. Go ahead and undo these buckles. And what you do is you just slide this through the buckle on one side, back on the other. Go ahead and cinch it up a little bit, and then feed this right back through your buckle. Got the other one here, I'm going to do the same thing with it. There's a little flap on this strap that you can see. I like to keep that flap down. I'll put it through that way, run it back through the other side. It's not going to make any difference, just a little better fit and finish that way. Run those through there. Okay, and that's it on those straps. Set those aside for now. This is a shoulder strap. Now this shoulder strap was designed to be one strap. It's fully reversible. You can use it on your right or left shoulder. I carry it on my left shoulder. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hook this buckle up, the one that comes straight off the end. I'm going to hook this on the right side over here. I'm going to hook this one to this side over here. These are bigger buckles than the two that hold the seat and the compression straps down. Now you've got two straps coming off the front also. Take the one that comes off of the top, put it in this side. Now when you go to put your pack on, you simply just lift it over your shoulder. very easy to use. And you can just adjust these up, straighten them up. I'm gonna go ahead and put my binocular system on here, my binocular harness. Always got my binoculars with me. Okay. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and put this on, and I'm gonna show you how to put this on. I just throw it over the top, hook my waist belt on. I'm not gonna cinch the waist belt up yet. I'm trying to see how much room I've got here and how comfortable it is on the side. I need to let this down just a little bit. And I'm gonna go ahead and pull on these straps to tighten it up. Nice fit. Now I want to take this and run it underneath my binocular system. Tighten that up. I'm going to do this one and run it back underneath my binocular. Now I've got full use of my binocular system. If I just put this on over the top of it, can't get my binoculars up to look through them. So it's pretty important to have that up through there. Go ahead and take that off. When I get to where I'm going, I just undo these buckles. I hold the end, undo it. Pack comes off. I'm ready to call in some coyotes. We've got this large double zippered pouch on the back. When I get to where I'm going, I'll set this next to me. I open it wide open. I've got access to all my calls. These are mesh screens. You can see which call you've got in each one of these. There's some Cordura pockets here. Your calls slide in there, easy access to get to. You can put some longer calls in there. I like to keep my Kai-Eye, my little dog, in there. Always keep a spare hot dog mouthpiece. You can put this is designed oversized. It'll hold the hot dog in here all by itself. You just slide them under these elastic loops. Put the mini mag in this side. You can have a Red Desert Howler in there if you'd like. Then you can put some smaller calls in down here also. Another nice thing we found out after we got this pack together is that you can put slates in these pouches, and you can put box calls in these elastic holders. So for you turkey hunters, this is a great advantage there. This compartment here unzips from both sides. Nice large pouch with a hard plastic back in it. Keeps from breaking things. You can store extra calls in here. You can see there's lots of room to put larger type calls in here. Double whammy, for instance, I keep that in there. These pouches on the side, this is designed to hold a roll of toilet paper if you need it. You can also, on the smaller pouches, you can put a little digital camera in here. I always have extra batteries in mine. I can put 8 AA batteries, 4C batteries, and a 9 volt in here. That way, if anything happens with my Fox Pro, I've got extra batteries with me all the time. I think that pretty much covers it. We've got the closed cell foam on the back here, and the open mesh. This helps to keep you cool on your back. Lots of padding in here, very comfortable to wear. These sides here, if you're like me and got some love handles, it's gonna open up around your love handles. If you don't have them, it works great that way too. These straps on the side, you can open this up, put your knife in here if you want. What I've got on mine is I've got a gunslinger holster on the one side, so when I carry my rifle on my right shoulder, I got that gunslinger. Keeps all the weight off my shoulder. I can carry it for hours. Now another nice thing we found out afterwards is since I have the Jim Horn pack that I use while I'm elk hunting, when I'm out calling elk and stuff, I like to sit down a lot when I'm calling for people. I just go ahead and take my little seat. I just clip it right on there, and I've got my seat to go with me when I'm calling elk too. Helps too if you got to kneel down. Last year we called a bull in and we were in the middle of a rock pile. Had to kneel down on the rocks, and by the time the bull got there, we were pretty shaky, and Scotty ended up missing him. But it works great for that. You can kneel on this, you can sit on it. Middle of the afternoon, you're gonna go out. It's getting hot and the elk aren't talking or anything. I just fold it up, taking many naps right there on top of that. Makes a great pillow. I designed this pack with the Fox Pro and the Jack in the Box in mind. One thing that I found about the Jack in the Box, it's a great decoy. I use it a lot, but one of the problems I had with it were these switches on the front. They were always getting turned on all the time. I needed a way to carry it so that wouldn't happen. What this pack does is it carries the Jack in the Box straight up. By carrying it straight up like that, and you can see how much higher this is, when this is zipped down, there's nothing gonna get in on those switches and bump those switches on. So you always know that you've got it turned off, and when it's time to go out and call in a coyote or a cat, you're ready to go. The FX3 fits in the side right there, or the 16 sound, either one of them. But for now, what I'm gonna do is we're gonna take you out in the field and show you how this works. This is a doggy bag. I don't know how many times I've carried coyotes out, or bobcats, and you sling them over your shoulder, and by the time you get back to the rig, you're covered in blood. This right here solves that problem. In the video, you'll see that I'm putting a liner in there. You don't have to. You can take this home, throw it in the wash machine, wash it. If your wife will let you, if not, maybe you gotta go out and hose it off outside. That's why I like to use the liners for them. Keeps it clean. These straps, you'll find that they just go around the legs of the coyote. You cinch them up, put them back on the clips. It's a great system. I've carried bobcats out with it. I've carried coyotes, even carried a badger out with it. One thing I found about the badger, though, is they don't have the dominant knuckle in their leg like the coyotes and the cats do. So I just went to one leg and put it on one leg of the badger, and it worked just fine. Well, thanks again for inquiring about the Predator Paradise Predator Pack, or if you've just purchased one, congratulations. I think you've got a phenomenal piece of equipment that's going to help you out a lot. It's going to make sure that you have all your equipment with you every time you go out in the woods. And there's nothing more frustrating than walking a mile in to call in a coyote, and you get there and your favorite call's at home. So hopefully this will be a good investment for you. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. Anything goes wrong with it, just give us a call. Thanks again.
I did.
Yeah. Well, we come in here this morning, we set up, started calling, used the turkey distress a little bit, nothing answered us or come in, so we went ahead and did the main how, and right away we got 6 or 7 coyotes to answer. That went back and forth a few times, and then we got a challenge, and I challenged him back, and big old male coyote circled all the way around him. All the way across on the other side of this meadow. We got on the far end of the meadow over there. I went ahead and did some pup distress. He turned to come across this way and went up into the trees. We're trying to find him. This grass is pretty tall out here and we couldn't see him. Next thing we know, we looked the other way and here come another coyote. And that coyote ran all the way across the field here, never even stopped. Then this guy come out here. He stopped and gave Jimmy a shot at 165 yards. Hit him right in the neck, tipped him over. The pelt on this coyote isn't very good. We're in the middle of summer here, but I'm gonna go ahead and put him in the doggy bag and show you how that works. Granddaddy was a hillbilly scholar, blue collar of a man. He came from the school where you didn't need nothing if you couldn't make it with your own two hands. He was backwoods. What we got here is a just a Johnny Cat litter bag. You can buy them at any grocery store. You get 5 of them for $2.50. And this just keeps the bag from getting dirty and make sure all the blood stays in there. Just gonna open that up. Lay the coyote in there. As you can see, there's a pretty good hole in this coyote. If you were to pack this out, you'd end up getting blood all over you, and this is gonna save your clothes. And we've got the straps that attach to the leg. You just open these straps up. I put them all the way down below the knee there, up as high as I can. Cinch that up tight. Take the other one, put it around the back legs. Still kicking and screaming at 93. I remember just how frail she looked. Cinch it up good. Hospital bed. We're gonna open the doggy bag up. Taking the last few breaths of life. Smiling as she said. It's got three Velcro straps on it. Undo those. Just a little step. Lay it open. Put this bag right inside. That's all there is to that. Close my pack back up. I never let a cowboy make the coffee. Yeah, that's what Granny always said. And on the front, on the strap, on the back of it, we just took the back legs to that. Never tell a joke that ain't that far. Put the front legs to the front of the shoulder strap. That's it. Now we can carry the coyote out of here. We're not going to get blood all over our pants. Keep us clean. Getting back to the rig and take some still pictures.